Hello, my name is Sjaak Bos. We are going to disassemble a Allison transmission, as you see here on this turnover stand. We have a torque converter housing. We have a main housing, and we have the rear cover or a retarder housing on the rear end. We also see an integral cooler installed. At the bottom side of the transmission, we will see the hydraulic controls. We are starting the disassembly with the removal of the torque converter housing with the torque converter included. All these tools and procedures are described in the Allison service manual for the specific transmission series. We are now going to remove the hydraulic controls. The torque converter has now been removed. This gives us access to some bolts that needs to be removed, and there is three of them located at the top side of the transmission. Now we start to remove external bolts. The next subject from the disassembly is the removal of the front support together with the rotating clutch housing. Here we have the gasket that is used for sealing the split line. Every split line has gaskets for a proper sealing. So, since this is a transmission with an integral cooler, we need to remove the cooler and its manifold before we can remove the retarder module. And we can lift the manifold for the integral cooler from the retarder housing. So, our next job is to remove the remaining bolts that holds the retarder module on the back of the main housing. This now gives us access to the rear components. I first grab the sun gear of the P3 carrier. This is our main shaft. Now we have access to the P3, P2 planetary components. You can see you can lift them out by hand. I now can remove as a pack the C5 clutch pack. And you can see the C5 clutch pack, it contains reaction plates of steel and friction plates in between. Now we remove the P2, P1 planetary assembly. What is left is the C3 and the C4 clutches and a P1 ring gear. So, 10 are out, 2 are holding the C3, C4 module inside. I need to rotate the housing upside down now to get that module out. Bolt number 11 and bolt number 12. And I take out the C3, C4 module. Job finished. This was the disassembly of the Allison 3000 series transmission. Thank you very much for watching, and I hope to see you next time.